Thank you very much. Okay, I want to start by letting everybody know that those job descriptions I just sent out are the wrong version. I accidentally sent out the wrong version, so I'll need to send them out again. But I just don't have them yet. They're on my work computer, I just realized. So I'll have to send those out tomorrow.
And I just put them on the website, or on the Google Docs. That's okay. I brought the wrong ones with me. I printed them off because we wanted to.
Yeah, that's wrong. One of the differences is the age. So Kelly and I thought it best that we, the assistant director and director, be 18 years old.
I noticed that. That was going to be one of my questions.
16-year-old director.
Yeah.
And then I just figured, well, you didn't want to discriminate.
No, it's one of those, I had left it there. We talked about that. So anyways, I'll send the new ones out tomorrow and you can post the new ones if you want. That'd be great.
Yeah, I'll take down these, remove these.
You got the edits from the board, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I incorporated all the edits.
Yeah, because I went back and checked when I printed them off. Mm-hmm. And it said in your email, including the edits.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Did everybody have a chance to look at the meeting minutes from last week? So can we, are we in a position to approve the minutes? How do we approve the minutes? I forgot now. Make a motion to approve the minutes from last week.
I'll make a motion to approve the minutes.
Second.
All in favor?
Oh, sorry. All in favor?
Opposed?
Opposed, right. I need a script. Every week we go through this. I'm telling you, every week.
I understand.
Anybody opposed? No? Okay.
Perfect.
All right, so Celia, you have an agenda item to give another t-shirts. Do you want to do yours first?
Okay.
After you get done writing?
Okay. So, I did get a little bit organized today. Some extra info. Okay. So, Lester, you asked what it would look like on the opposite green shirt. So this is what it would look like unless we buy different ink.
Unless we buy different ink. So this is the...
So this is what the same ink's on a black. But to put it on the green, you have to buy different inks because it blends right in.
Is it one color ink or is it two?
That's two.
Okay.
You have to buy different inks.
Because it's blending in. It's not popping out. You can't see it very well. So you have to buy a different shade of green
or a blue.
It's not so much the buying the ink as the setup for the printer. So he's going to have to restart over completely, recalibrate two new sets of ink, and that could increase your cost. Instead of just printing all the shirts one after another after another, that's how it costs. So it's possible, but it would cost you more. So we'd have to do two different.
So it would be two different setup fees. Or two different costs because you're doing two different shirts.
Yep, he'd have to completely stop the presses, start all over, recalibrate new colors. So
if we were to do like the blue and the black, then
yep,
it would
you
remain the same.
Yep.
So if we just went with different colors from both of them. Well, let's say we went with, I don't know, red and purple. That would work on both the shirts. I mean, I don't suggest those colors. But
yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
So Kristen's suggestion would be, one of her suggestions was to go with a darker color in which the same inks would show up on. So go with like the blue and the black.
Right.
Yeah, I don't suggest the black though because they're going to be baking out there.
And people don't want to wear black. I mean, my son only wears black, but most people like don't want to buy black.
About like a gray.
So do we have to do a
two-tone logo? Yeah, so if you go gray, you need all the inks.
Oh, you would.
Yeah.
Good question.
Do we have to do a two-tone logo or can it be... Like a just example, bright blue shirt, and maybe...
You could just do white.
The label be black or white. I mean, not the label.
Black wouldn't show up on the blue shirt. But you could do white on the blue shirt.
So it's an option. It doesn't need to be two-tone, though.
No. but you want to kind of decide because you're going to be selling them next week. Or what about?
Correct.
Possibly.
And these trees will.
So you kind of want to know because you want to have. You have to know soon so that you can have something to show people.
Well,
what would be a good option if we kept the two tone?
What's wrong with the blue?
We were trying to designate staff and campers.
Yeah, so what's the reasoning behind that? Because if you're in a huge group and you have different groups,
because if a kid is quickly trying to find a staff member.
But what if they just find a different group? Because it's going to be, like if you go to the pool, you're going to find people who are different colors. Do you know what I mean?
From different camps.
From different camps.
Right.
So maybe if someone goes, it's Raleigh, like the
yeah.
working at the place will not look for blue.
Right. Yeah.
And
true.
The staff will.
And they're taller than the campers.
And they're generally taller.
And they're going
to
have this written across their back.
Then,
this is
like,
what the staff looks like
sixth
on the back.
Grade, who's like as tall as me.
And Roxanne, when I wrote that it would cost us more to do two color, came back and asked me, why not just do one color? What's wrong with one color?
Mm-hmm. And she wasn't able to make it to the last meeting.
I understand one color, but that's a pretty vocal. Doesn't come out. Right.
Well,
it comes out on the blue.
It would be on this blue.
Yeah,
everybody would be in the
blue.
What about the logo? But I mean,
on
your
the
logo with the trees. Like, I like it.
Yeah.
It's you.
Yeah, I think that'd be great.
What is the extra cost for having it two colors?
The more color you add, the more.
Right, but what
like
is
a
it?
Setup fee is like $250 around there, isn't it? Or is it
so here's what it would look like, the front would look like on the shirts.
Yeah, let me see.
On the blue. Still with the two colors.
I like that.
And I still really like that, by the way.
You like the
vertical? I know.
Vertical?
What's wrong with that? That's so cool, right?
See?
I designed it. But it's kind of like all the Nordic skiers and biathlon, they have that.
I like it because
like Deutschland has that.
Because every other place is going to have staff.
Yes, it's definitely visible.
Well, we voted on it, so I'll let it go.
We voted
last
though.
Sorry.
I vote to repeal Obama honorary in Illinois.
Yeah, that's the original shirt.
Which we all like, you know, the original blue.
I like the blue. I like this.
Yeah.
Yep. I like that.
So the problem's resolved if we just go with the staff
same
color.
Just go with color.
Because the three options Kristen laid out for me were one, you go with two dark colored shirts, so two blues, and then you stay with the inks. Number two, you change your inks, which would increase your cost if you go with a green shirt and a blue shirt. And then the third option, I
didn't get whatever it was. I think it had to do with selling to people because people really want to buy them. I get lots of orders on this.
Really?
Yeah. Jenny Priester? She's super excited. She's like, I want two. Everybody loves the idea because everybody loves Rollinsford, you know?
That's great. So I didn't print it off.
So what do you think about the staff on the back, the rec staff? And we voted not to do that, right? Not to do the
it's
going to
be
yeah.
North Donald.
Well, just I mean, it's just easier to spot. If you, for example, if you're at the pool and you need somebody way down there. You like the...
I just like the coolness of
it.
But
it is
cool to go with the majority.
So this is where the three options. Go with the one color shirt across the board.
Yeah.
That this is the easiest and least expensive. Number two, go with one color for the whole camp, but go for a second color to sell to the public, like the black, which it would show up on, and then we know they're not affiliated with the camp, they just bought the shirt.
Except I'd say white versus black, so like you say people don't.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah,
because I don't think people are going to want to buy black.
And then,
there's
depending
a navy,
on,
but it doesn't, there's no navy for kids.
Did you just say the ones for sale would be white?
That's my thought.
Yeah, okay.
It's but what about
tricky,
maybe
these inks actually don't show up very good on white either.
What's that?
It would just the inks just
the inks don't show,
don't show
up
very good on white.
So that
ink
would grow
is a huge process. It seems like nothing.
How about the light grayish kind of color?
Yeah, but disappears on it. You have to go really dark. It seems like it would work. Trust me, but I've tried mock-ups as well. Do you have a mock? We have.
I don't.
So the
same
ones
have
olive white or light color. Because then we're getting into, again, another expensive shirt.
Although the guy at Seagull's Printing is really nice. He's trying really hard to keep it cheap.
And
I can't believe his price.
To Caroline, and he gives the town a discount.
Oh, Yeah, he must have, because it's really good prices.
Could we go with like a that color blue and then like a darker blue for the staff?
Here, this is what the
Yeah, that guy's actually wearing navy.
Oh, look at those black.
So this is the
mock-up. It's like a dark marine navy.
These are printed,
it's just the way it's printed.
The sun shoe.
Well, those ones would be sent to sale.
Yeah, see, there's gray and white,
oh, okay.
But each of these are
yeah,
much darker
the
general
public sale.
Okay.
Yeah.
So she sent me these, but these are different inks, which means that we'd have to pay for a whole other setup.
Wow, I like that color thing.
The gray's kind of fun because it's kind of retro. Like old captures, like we had when we were children.
The green
like
and the blue are so
little. Oh, wait, this is what the color changes, right?
Yeah, it is this is more of a forest green, and that's
to get
more of a
work.
Is this like a vintage?
Yeah.
I love that.
Do you like that? Oh, good. I was hoping, I didn't know.
Did you see that one?
I know, there's a way to do it.
So you notice the difference?
Well,
I like that. But that
like
on navy
I see.
What about this on navy blue?
Play around a little bit, you know.
I do kind of like that.
Yeah, it's like surf shirt, you know?
Yeah. So maybe like something like that on a navy blue with that.
But if we do that, how much do you think the price would go up?
I don't know. I could find out, though.
So what is the price point right now?
So for the blue, it's $650.
Okay. For sure.
Adults or kids. But I'm thinking if we're going to sell them to the public and we want to do a different color, we could always charge like $10 to
you
the public.
Should definitely.
Oh, I would,
yeah.
So
and then
t-shirt
you could do gray and then you would cover the extra cost possibly.
Like,
I like the gray actually.
The retro one.
Yeah, well, I think the gray in general is kind of nice. You think?
Mm-hmm. I like the gray. Yeah, the gray's perfect. And the gray comes in kids too, if you guys are selling to kids and adults. The kids' shirt colors are limited. So there's no navy or a lot of colors that the kids just don't have.
So if we went with the gray, I'd be interested to find out what the difference is in price and how much it's going to go up for
a
shirt.
Yeah, see that's my, if you just keep it to one extra addition in cost, like this, like just one. It's hard to explain. I don't want you to, see, every time you change something, there's a thousand factors that change on my end. So if you keep it to just the one shirt color, that might not be too bad. But if you did like different for staff and residents and...
Well, I think we have to do different for residents because we don't want
someone
buying a shirt and then walking
right
there and...
Yeah, I totally agree. And also the kids, like if they buy a kid's shirt, I don't know if you're gonna sell kids shirts, but then kids could be showing up to the
right.
Think that they can wear it, like if they're in the camp and they wear it, and then it doesn't have the sponsors, because sponsors are really, you have to take really good care of your sponsors. So if you have sponsor shirts, you have to wear your sponsor shirts.
Well,
this way they wouldn't get mixed up.
So that's a good point. So with the sponsor shirts, they have their own logos, I'm assuming. So everything how would we do that so it's compatible with the shirts? I mean, is it possible?
Yep.
So whatever. Some gives you. Okay.
The sponsors, well, I'm thinking they're not going to go on the, are they going, I don't think they're going to go on the town.
No,
shirts,
they
right?
go on
Yeah,
the
so they'll
shirts.
Just be on the kids, right?
Yeah,
yeah, they can't be on the staff.
Because they have staff.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that'll be no problem.
Okay, so, all right.
I'll lay that out for you.
So what do you guys think about the blue that we had originally looked at for the campers and the staff and then the gray for the selling for the town.
Yeah, but the problem there is that's a whole different setup because it's different colors.
It is a different ink setup.
Right, true.
But we can find out how
but
much.
If we can find out what the difference is in cost per t-shirt, then we could, maybe we originally bought $10 per shirt,
right.
Maybe they were 11 or 12.
And we just said that we were going to pre-order them so we'd know how many to order. We weren't going to buy a bunch of them and then try and sell them. We didn't want to get stuck with them. Mm-hmm. It was all going to be a pre-order for the community. They would have to give us their money up front.
Yep.
Does the community really want to buy them?
I got a bunch of people who want them. But maybe just the, just like the...
People start seeing other people with them.
Yeah. There's a lot of people who like the Raleigh thing. Right? I've already got a bunch.
Yeah, I think
maybe the older people won't buy them.
So maybe when Kelly gets here, we can just run it by her real quick and see what she thinks, and then we can take a vote on it.
Good could create kind of a thing where every year we have these shirts and it could, you know, flow of money coming in.
Exactly, because it's a way to support, you know.
Plus you get a cool t-shirt.
Plus you get a t-shirt, which is great. It's a way to raise money, which is awesome. Okay, so I'll find out how much it would be to switch over the inks for the gray.
Yeah, if you could do that, that would be great.
Yes,
hello. Well, you're just in time. We're just talking about t-shirts. Now we're going to give you a rundown. All right.
So, to get two colors, there's on the bottom there is the shirt that we said we wanted for the green. It doesn't come out very well, which means we would have to buy a whole new set of inks. Because the gray shirt there, the gray, the white, and the green would have to be different colors than the blue and the black because they don't show up on those colors. So we decided that nobody wants to be in black all day long and that maybe we should go with blue for the staff and the campers and that the staff will have staff written on the back and then have gray for the community and charge them more money if they want to buy them. And then people in the community can't walk up to the camp and say, I'm part of this camp.
Yeah.
If we're going to put the setup charge for the different color, for the gray, into the cost of the gray, then we can do this with that setup color. Correct?
Probably. Maybe. I can try it. But at that, then what's happening is you're ordering several colored shirts from the printer, and the printer has minimums that he has to purchase from his vendor.
Okay,
so what's
going to
happen is your shirt prices might go up. Like, there's always something going up, so I'm always trying to keep it cheap.
All right, never mind. I just was thinking about that.
But yeah, maybe inks on the green and gray would go together. But the green might be a little bit dark. But
so what are we just saying, just stay with this for everybody at camp and then have these for community? I already have two people want to buy two of these.
All right, fine.
So is it possible to get, just for giggles, to get a prototype, to get a shirt like that for Saturday?
To, like a sample?
Yeah.
That would be expensive, right?
Yeah.
But we,
because the setup. If you think about, he's screen printing, he's burning screens,
right.
And then he's taking his machines and setting them aside, and you have to run. I mean, I don't know how it is now, because I'm not in there now. It's a lot more automated now, but it used to be that you have to run 50 shirts before it was calibrated correctly. So they lose a lot of product. So just do one is quite expensive. But he might be able to do like a direct-to-print one, I could ask him, which is like a...
I think just having a bunch of those in color.
Yeah, I'm thinking I'll just make you, I can make you a mock-up poster that looks better, because that looks kind of dirty. I can make it look better than that.
Well, there's, if you look at the logos color, there's two different, see that one's more of a, that's like a vintage, crushed out, and that one's, those are the regular ones.
Yeah.
Oh, that's funny. I was like, I
like
the
regular. Shocker. But so honestly, we have different opinions.
I know. I really don't care. But so whatever.
What's that? If you do the
are they the
vintage,
same price?
Yeah. Because I do.
Yeah,
it's more if you have them do it, but I know how to do it, vector. So it might be softer because less ink.
Yeah.
A big patch of ink is not that comfy.
Oh,
but
true.
if it's a little bit less, it'll be softer.
So what is the cost like? For 50 shirts in that gray color to sell on Saturday.
Well, he wouldn't be able to do them by Saturday.
Okay.
He needs like a 3 week. That's why we had the deadline.
Yeah. It was supposed to be the February 27th, which was the Monday after our last meeting, and he could have gotten something
ready
for
that. He would have done a rush order for you with no extra cost, but he can't do it now because it's
too short.
Well, I think for Saturday it'd be really good to have.
Just
and that is on
that
the
picture.
Google Drive too.
Yeah.
I uploaded it. There's a whole folder, or there should be now, of just t-shirt information, and it's got the size charts and all of that.
So if that's the case, then and we're advertising it, then we need to have a cost
that's
associated
cute.
With it too.
That's nice.
So
I'd
do
like
we go to $10 price point?
I make a motion to make $10 for the gray shirt.
Should we find out how much they are first?
I have a feeling if it goes up, it'll be like 50 cents a shirt at the most. And there's six
so that's $3.
Okay.
That's what I'm hoping.
Yeah.
I can't promise it.
So, Jovi, you can make a motion for $10?
Yeah.
It's a pretty cheap t-shirt.
I know, $10 is so cheap. T-shirt is great, but you might sell a ton if it's 10.
Tens again, even.
Yeah, and
tens an even number. Give me two. Here's $20.
Or you can do 12 or 2 for $20.
Oh.
So, just the gray for sale.
The gray for sale for the community, and it's all pre-order, so we're not stuck with a bunch of shirts that we have to get rid of later.
And there we will. And it's prepay, right? So are they like we're doing that on Saturday, right? Taking money and
sure, I guess.
Yeah, what if people, like, what if they just want to sign up to get one? Because they didn't bring money. Because I don't usually bring money.
So I'm going to sign up, shoot information.
I do bring money. I pay off my slipboard. No, I don't usually bring money, so there might be people.
Wait, I know I'm not getting any money.
So I'll prepare a sign up sheet then.
Yeah.
With details.
Yeah, but maybe they can circle their size. Phone number or email, depending on, some people don't like to be called.
So I like the 12 or 2 for 20.
I thought you were saying like the 10 and 2 for 20.
No, I was saying 10 is an even number.
The fire department sells t-shirts. Do you know what they cost? I have bought quite a few of
my I don't remember.
That's a good idea.
$10, 2 for 20 actually is a great idea.
12. You mean?
I mean, yeah. 10, yeah. Sorry. Yes.
So, Lester, are you making a motion? 1 for 12?
You had made a motion, but then we ignored it.
No one seconded.
I didn't know how long it stays.
It's gone.
Slowly saying.
Can we re-motion?
All right.
No one seconded.
Since nobody seconded, it sort of disappeared.
Yeah, it just disappeared. You guys just stare at me.
All right, so I make a motion that we sell these at $12 a piece or 2 for 20. And then we do the pre-order at the
meeting.
Town meeting.
Yeah.
Do you want to do kids too for the gray, right?
Yeah.
So I'm gonna try to get them.
Wait, before it sinks.
Just for a second.
Okay.
Oh, just okay. Now.
Second.
Well,
second.
Sorry, I'm not
I'll second
it.
That.
I'll try to
sorry,
get
the
samples. Do you have size samples?
I forwarded them the size sheets.
Yep. So, and I'm thinking if he gives us samples for town meeting, we could.
Yeah, because I would want to know how much cotton is and how much is it going to shrink.
And did we?
Yeah.
We decided last meeting about the softer shirt.
Yeah,
yes,
the 650s for the good shirt, which is amazing.
And is that for this as well, the same price?
Yeah, okay. Same shirt. That's the same make. I know, it's cooler too.
The fire department t-shirt's a 10.
By two?
And what if we have, would you be able to have like...
Well then it'll cost you $32.
The logo to like just show...
Not so two on one?
Yeah, for, do you want it for time?
For demonstration?
Yeah.
That gets complicated.
Yep, I can make you a pretty big mock-up of that. I'll make like a little poster of my shirt. And then, yeah, would you like just the logo?
Yeah, so that we can buy on
Yeah, I'll ask him too if maybe he can do a direct print one.
And the
just
logo
to
is on the website, or on Google Docs too.
Mm-hmm.
Dee forwarded it to me exactly.
And the poster. That's
awesome poster.
Yeah, that Lego lady is completely photoshopped. I completely made her.
You did?
Yeah, the guy is Benny from the movie, which I haven't seen. But I guess the whole Lego booth is about copyright and all the it is all about them wanting freedom.
Yeah,
and the bad guy's like Mr. Corporation or something. So Lego would totally support us. And we're not selling Lego t-shirts, which is good. So stand by, it's safe. Yeah, you're welcome. It's really fun.
And I don't know if you're in charge of the sponsorship.
I brought stuff for that.
Okay, because I got two people already lined up.
No. Well, no. Lester made a motion to sell the shirts for $12, or two for $20, with sign up at town meeting, and Roxanne seconded.
That's who got.
So you didn't decide on the price, you gotta vote on your price.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any nays? Sounds good to me.
I just wanna make sure.
Good thing you're here, now I'm about to sink again.
Sponsorships. Yeah, so the sponsorship, so right now I have, I talked to Steve Lawrence, who owns Aqua Paradise Pools, and they are willing to write a check. He asked me like 3 days ago, who do I write it out to, and, so I was like, oh wait, you're way ahead of me, I don't know the answer to that question.
Kristen forwarded me, these are not correct text, but these are, I updated it.
Yeah.
Earlier today. So this is what the sponsors, the like pamphlet that would go out to the sponsors would look like. And I did create a rough draft of text with sponsorship levels on it. So I only brought one copy.
Okay.
And I've already been in touch with C&J.
Okay.
I had a contact over there with my sister-in-law, and so I've gone back and forth a couple times, and she's like, oh, I don't know anything about the program, can you tell me more? So I just kind of told her, and I was like, well, we're looking, I mean, I don't even know how much money are we looking for?
I put the levels at $250 to $300 for the top, for five businesses only.
Yeah.
And then one of the options she gave me was like, sponsor a camper, so I put that at $240.
Yeah.
And then one was sponsor a counselor, I put at $30 so that we could get buy all of their shirts. And then there's join the Camp Raleigh Army,
which
was
is
$10.
Yeah, buying a gray shirt.
It says our staff is 100% volunteer.
No, that's why that one is. He's got the correct text.
I didn't know.
Should we let them know that?
Well, together you worked on this? Okay.
So, yeah, I just updated the text today. I changed some of the things, like the staff is not, our committee, the rec committee, who runs this program is 100% staff, not volunteer, but there will be 8 to 10 well-qualified staff there and stuff like that. And that, and she put in like some of the activities and stuff we're doing. So there are some changes to the text in the company.
Yeah, I think whenever we refer to Summer Rec now, we should say Camp Raleigh.
Yeah.
So it's one of the changes I would make.
Oh, I like that.
We'll have to get them to have those fans.
So,
I talked to, and well, C&J, the woman I talked to, well, actually, we didn't speak, it was all via email. But, you know, I kind of said, well, I said, I think we're looking for at least $800. So I did. I said, feel free to donate as much as you want.
But I think we did
start high.
That's awesome.
I was like, anywhere from $250 to $800, so we wouldn't be upset if you went the 800 route, or I said something like that.
But Kristen said the top level should be limited to 5.
Yeah.
And if you, I don't know if you
just
guys.
Just it'll work on the shirt.
Right, and I was just at the Children's Museum last Thursday with my kids. And Henry Garrison School was there with theirs, and their kids, and they had purple shirts with little green wave on it, and they had 5 sponsors on the back, like in the next pattern.
Just so I'm clear, so the more money they spend, the bigger their logo,
right?
Yeah. Okay.
Yes.
And will that be
the 5 main, and then I don't know how you guys want to do it after that. If you want everyone to get on the shirt, it could just be text. That's what you usually do with like a running race, right? Or it could be small logos and then text for the really.
Is there any price difference?
There is. Oh, no, not for you guys.
No.
The price difference would be for the sponsor.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So would it just be text, or would it be like they had a JPEG logo thing?
Maybe they
can choose or decide, right?
I think it's based on the sponsorship
level. Based on the amount of money they give you.
Okay.
You guys get to choose. So you can do big logos and then small logos. And then text.
Okay.
If you want to do 3 levels, if you want to do 2 levels, it could be big logos, then small logos, which will probably fit just fine on a shirt. If your sponsors have Vector, this is what's important. If your sponsors have Vector logos, that's important. Because they have to be Vector to get printed. If they're not Vector, I have to completely recreate them, which takes hours. I've done it. And I actually have a lot of the people in town because of the salmon run. I've actually redrawn all their logos already.
So maybe these stupid.
But usually they have a Vector
big logo as these stupid texts.
Vector just means it can be printed up forever.
But I think join the camp,
but it needs to
Raleigh
do that for screen printing.
If somebody sponsored. So yeah, so but if somebody individually sponsors a camper, that's not going on the t-shirt, correct?
No, I don't think so, because that's just, well, I don't know, that's a lot of money actually.
It is $30, so this is, we have to, I mean.
You could ask them, like,
no,
do you want.
At least $240 was sponsor a camper.
That's spoiled, yeah, that's a lot actually.
That's a lot.
But if you don't know, if it's a person, like, I don't want my name on a t-shirt.
Yeah,
because
no, I think if it's a business, it goes on. So the Camp Hero, I'm thinking the big five sponsors need to have their logo on.
Definitely,
there.
I think.
Sure. Sponsor a camper, I think we decide as a group what to do as a thank you for that person as a sponsor camper besides putting their name on the shirt.
Oh yeah, and you always want to give, you always want to give your big sponsors a shirt. Always give them a shirt.
So the top fives.
Wait a minute, so now.
So those Camp Heroes would get a shirt.
Can I write on this?
Yeah.
So now we're going to have people running around with the same shirts as our staff.
No, it would be a different color.
You could give them the gray shirt.
Yeah.
But the gray isn't going to have their logo on the back, and that's the whole.
That's true. Well, then you could give them one of the kids' shirts after the program's over. Or, I mean, I don't think they're going to abuse it. I don't think C&J is going to be like, hey.
Their gift doesn't come until after the season's over anyway, just like baseball. So you never give your sponsor the gift back. The season's over anyway.
That makes sense. Okay, so that would work.
And then next year we're going to go.
You're going to change the color anyway. Every year your shirt color changes. I'm assuming.
That would be fun. Then you could do like
usually
fiery orange and red.
Right.
I'm already on to the next one.
Because your theme may change every year.
In regards to your question, sponsor a camper, she had $80 because that's what it was last summer. And that would not get us
a camper sponsor.
That would sponsor 2.5 weeks. So we could drop that down to 240. I just put 240 in there because it would cover the whole camp.
Yeah. That is a lot. That's almost like a hero.
Yeah. And I put
this one too different than
this is the old
sponsor
one.
Camper.
Because that's the old
then
that was the old price.
You can get a lot more people.
Exactly.
Okay, that's what we'll do
that. So the prices the prices on there can all come down.
Yeah.
Right.
Or be negotiated. I just put in prices.
Okay.
If you get five people to sponsor one kid, it's still better.
Yeah.
And join the camp, join the Camp Raleigh Army is a minimum. Is like pay $10 to help support the program or to help send somebody there.
And does that person then get a shirt? And that's cheaper than buying a shirt.
I think we should give sponsors this.
You could do that. That costs like $12.
In their office.
I think that actually cost me, I think that was $14. But you might be able to get a deal somewhere else. I got it at Staples for you guys.
Or a coffee mug.
Sponsors most sponsors don't usually.
Right. Well, that's what I'm thinking. I'm like, why, but, you know.
Right.
Why get my
t-shirts? Downstairs.
I say a thank you note to me with all the kids.
Yeah. Because it saves the
lead. And prints from kids.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Something
that
says
no.
Thank you.
No. Big note. And prints.
So we just X-made the shirts?
For sponsors.
So all sponsors.
Do we get there's a lot of power, that's one thing, but I wouldn't spend any extra.
Yeah.
Especially this year and
first
year.
Yeah.
They understand.
So no
shirts. Thank you letters.
Okay,
so should we keep this at 240 or should we drop it?
The kids can bake them some brownies.
What if you do
we
like
can make
one version five?
That has the people down low in all black at the top and the kids could all sign it in like silver and then they could
for
put it up.
The,
it'd be pretty cool.
Instead
yeah,
of, and then it's in the middle. And if you get two people to do 125, then you get
120.
Or 120, you get.
I like that better. I think more people
sponsor half a kid.
half a kid, legs only.
So then suck and half they want. What side?
So
that'd be great. You could have like a little animated, like if you had a website and animated, it'd be like Hangman, you know? From the body, led leg to it, we got a full kid.
So you wanna run a website? That's what I just heard.
That'd be fun.
So
yeah, that'd be fun. We'll definitely put a page on the town website, LSTM.
So I think they did sponsor a camp where we dropped it.
Is there a page? I think it's just in there.
I got it going.
Oh yeah, the Facebook is great.
Haven't really done anything since, but I got it going.
Yeah, it looks.
So this needs to be.
Yes, I was thinking of working.
So we decided anything that's gonna be approved is gonna go through Dan from now on. Okay, Dan?
Dan's our.
Okay, Dan's our proofer.
By the way, I hear from the kids at St. Thomas that you're a good teacher, you're fair, but it's not an easy class.
Is it English?
Yeah.
Okay.
And they weren't shocked about all your corrections for us.
So yeah, that's a compilation of what Kristen put together and what I put together, and it'll go on that format there. And on that, there's a place for us to put our information and to have somebody sign it.
Is there a favorite one?
I don't know.
Do you want me to?
Does it say everyone volunteered?
Do you want me to read a couple letters first, or do you want to take this right now?
Yeah, this one's the same one that I read.
There's just a few basic things, like summer rec programs, change to Camp Raleigh. I mean, there's things like that.
Yeah, I mean, maybe
sponsors.
That sort of stuff. Do you want to go through it first and send it over to me, or do you want to just do this right now on this copy you're saying?
Well, I think in the spirit of getting through the agenda, maybe.
All right, yeah, I can take a look.
Yeah, I'm going to be able to.
This says two rec t-shirts, but we're thinking of three, I thought.
Yes, so that's.
Summer rec should be known as Camp Raleigh.
Yeah, where possible.
Relabeling.
Yeah.
Rebranding.
We're going to rebrand this puppy.
Nice.
All right, so we know the amount of sponsorships. So are you going to tell him 700?
So do we need to vote on this?
They could be really.
250, 120?
Yes, we need to vote on because it's money related.
Okay.
So what did you want for the camp hero?
Oh, right.
Which one was that one?
Camp Heroes is one.
Oh, that's the top one? I think we should, I've already said 250 to two companies, so, or more.
To eight.
Or eight.
So let's go 250 on that.
So that's the top.
Tier.
Top tier.
Okay.
And they get with that, so the Camp Heroes, 250s, they get their logo on the back.
Yep.
Okay.
This is half, 120.
And is that limited?
What the price of one kid is. So that's
really limited.
How many people? Oh, companies.
Right.
So we're going to change this to sponsor half a camper.
20 companies on top here.
Yeah.
Which is a good problem to have.
Half of a man.
What?
It's a good problem to have. Strike the logo.
Yeah.
To get 20 on there.
And so she's suggesting five, and that would bring us to over 1,000. That'd be 1,250.
So cap it at five.
Yeah,
okay.
That'd be great if we can do that.
And do we have to cap any other ones sponsored?
No.
No?
Okay, so then.
Who's a $10 one too?
120 to.
Yeah, she has
to.
For sponsor camper.
That's basically five T.
And are they getting their names on the shirt?
For which one?
Sponsor camper. Are we listing
them?
I
don't think so.
No.
No.
Okay.
You could always put a thing.
No, I think they get some names.
Some people probably
do
that non-political.
Is that still
sorry.
Politically correct? Do you want that out there?
Is Latchkey in the quote?
No, it's not.
Or
is
Latchkey?
It's
incorrect.
Did we
out
that out there?
Latchkey?
What
are you referring to there?
Campers who need a scholarship are often latchkey kids.
Meaning their parents
don't want to put them in.
I don't want her out at all.
Sorry.
Celia didn't write that.
Now, you want to stay positive about anyone that you would like to,
to give a camper.
The text on that is not correct. It's just the format we're looking at on those.
Are often in need.
Yeah.
Or some kids need scholarships.
We'll be able to do that without it. I mean, my son wouldn't have been able to.
without tuition assistance, some kids are unable to enjoy their summer or something like that.
How about just leaving it? This is a huge gift to give a camper who needs it.
Yeah, or otherwise.
Otherwise not be able to attend.
Yeah, that's quote that. It's a good group.
Yeah, I'm gonna limit it to family, the number of children can I'm trying to word it right, so something mean. The number of children that can take advantage of being sponsored per family.
Oh, I see, like one child per family, is that what you mean?
How if we have money for three and only one person steps up and their sibling wants to come? Just
yeah,
the first one for
I mean, I don't know. The family that need it for one kid probably needs it for all of them. Other people don't. Like, they wouldn't need it for one.
That's kind of tough to say,
it's
right?
It's too hard
to
know.
Right,
do you just reduce the cost at a certain level?
Well, here's a question.
Are we
specifying who these people are actually sponsoring? Or
no.
Are we just saying
no?
No. Okay.
I think it would just help you guys take.
So we can have a little.
The only people that are going to know are going to be you and the select board.
Okay.
And Carol.
And that's the people approach us regarding, right?
Does
help?
It say anywhere on our flyers or anything about?
Do other camps do this?
Tuition assistance or whatever.
No, we haven't done that.
Specifically, we've not done
that.
Because
if people need assistance, they're going to call and they're going to ask.
Just,
they're going to email.
Yeah, we talked about this. It's not something we want to really advertise.
Right.
Because
what if we have influence that we can't offer it?
Thank you.
Yeah, I think we should stipulate that this is only for Rollinsford kids, correct?
Tuition assistance.
Yeah, because you're going to open up the floodgates if
right.
you don't. For the possibility of a floodgate.
Yes. Are you signed up?
I have all at home filled out. I just haven't.
Jody, did you get any registration in Caroline by any chance?
I haven't checked my desk.
One came in, right?
On Monday, Caroline told me she had gotten one on Monday.
All right. We'll have to make up. I told her, she emailed me and said, all right, we'll pick up on certain days and
yeah.
come collect. All right,
okay,
what else?
Okay, so we got to go back for a minute. We got a little side direct.
So we vote on those fees?
No, we did not, because we only... So we went through the sponsorship tier, $250 for a Camp Hero logo on the back of the shirt, and that's capped at 5 sponsors. $120 to sponsor a camper, no emblem on the shirt, and thank you later. And then, do you want to stick with $30
mm-hmm.
for a counselor?
Yeah, that'll cover their shirt.
$30, sponsor a counselor, and that covers their shirt.
So you still have, with 5, at this rate, you have 5 big logos on the shirt, and that still leaves you a good portion of the shirt. I don't know if you want to have another, I mean, I know having several levels can be silly, but.
I think
you still have room on the shirt for more, but if you just want to have 5, that's...
I mean, I guess if a business wanted to sponsor a kid, you could just put them, we want the $250.
Well, the problem is if you have an onslaught of others, then if there's not room for, you know, everybody, I don't know how this is going to go.
Yeah.
That would
so
be a good problem to have, though.
It would be. Yeah. Everybody wants to give us money. So I think just keep it at the 5 that hopefully we're going to get.
Who are you working
on? Yeah, we've already possibly got 2 5.
But actually, it's another good question, and then a leading would be, so once we get these all finalized, do we start like mass mailing to people, local businesses, these?
We could, or go door to door. I mean, I know some of the... I know some of the people at the mill. I know the guy who runs Fig Tree.
Mm.
And
Mike.
Mike, and he's got a place at Strawberry Bank now. He runs a cafe out of there. And then, I don't know, I see the lady, one of the people who works at Risty's when I go to Storytime on Thursdays.
So can we get a couple of people that want to volunteer to start doing that?
Okay.
If you want to, you don't have to say it. I know you've got a lot going on. So Kathy, and does anybody else want to help Kathy?
Wants to start making some calls.
Yeah.
Calling people.
Well, or are we walking around handing them out?
I think either way, it's just...
I had just thought, since that was part of the t-shirts, I was going to help out people.
Okay, Cecilia, Kathy, Roxanne, did three of you want to take that task on?
It's $2,500.
But you're cool.
And then, because the effort she gives at CJ goes to do anything. And then there's the $5,300, especially. That's what the stamp on the shirt is. And then there's all the tickets. Very generous.
And so the three of you can just, you maybe get to get on the side and figure out how you want to coordinate together to get, be going on those. Or get those distributed or calls or however you want to.
Yeah.
It'd be great. And then next meeting, you can just tell us how you're doing. I don't mind you, I mean, I think everybody too can have a role, and if they know people with businesses, take the... If you want to send it out too when it's finalized, send it out to everybody.
And like Kristen had said, Wentworth Douglas can...
Yeah, could be really generous.
Could be a good sponsor.
I'm actually trying to get contact for Liberty too.
And do through the works, and then Liberty, maybe.
You just sponsor it. Check that contact name.
If you can get that first, then you go for it.
Have you contacted somebody in the past?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you can tell me after who was and you'll avoid.
Okay.
So then we have the $10 Camp Raleigh Army, right?
It's not for me, so...
Yep.
Okay, and that's...
Yeah.
So...
Camp Raleigh, and no emblem on the shirt, that just goes to the general ones. Is that correct?
She goes on the calls.
Awesome.
They all send it.
Well, I'm sorry. But if you do it, if you do the social...
So that's a question. She, Kristen brings up that to sponsor a, to become a member of the Army, it's $10, but should we bump it to $12 and then they can get a shirt to go?
I thought we weren't giving anyone any shirts. We're just doing thank you cards. So $10 is fine.
Because people will just buy shirts. You should just not have it.
Or we could...
Do you have a red pen? I love that.
Or we could just call being a member of the Army when you purchase a $12 shirt.
Right, well that was kind of the point of that, was that, to buy a shirt. It was just, or you can buy a shirt.
So, do we want to raise it from 10 to 12 so it matches the cost of the shirt? And when you,
or
you can say thank you. And then we could have a standard like thank you card, thank you for joining the Raleigh Army, and we could send it out to everybody who buys a shirt.
I think we have a standard card. You think? What are your thoughts?
I think for a $12 shirt, you know, you gave us $12, we gave you a shirt, and now we're also going to send you a thank you card.
No, people would be happy just to
cut their grass.
That's a lot of cost.
So just, do we want to keep that bottom tier $10 or do we want to open to $12?
They're buying a shirt, why are you sending them a thank you card?
No.
We're not.
Okay, no. Just want to make sure I heard that.
So,
I think this, personally,
I agree.
Just go away.
I agree.
Buy a t-shirt and proceeds go into our pocket.
So
let's
get rid of the...
Get rid of
Camp
Raleigh
Army.
Let's have these three things here.
Okay.
All right. Okay.
That's good.
Everybody okay with that? Eyes.
Oh, is it mine?
Need to vote on that.
Okay.
Everybody okay with that? We have three levels.
So 250, 150, and 30. That's our sponsorship tier.
Yep.
The term. This is all.
And we got.
This is more the layout.
We need a vote on this. Is everybody okay with these, having these three as they are laid out and presented by Celia? Everybody in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
So did you
nays?
Oh, wait.
Anyone opposed?
Just a second.
I'm rolling here. I have had a long day.
So you made a motion to accept the sponsorship tier as written. With top three sponsors only.
Is that what we're going to be handing out to businesses?
Yes.
As soon as it gets.
The two pages, right?
Two pages, when it gets revamped.
So Celia will re-edit it and then distribute it to everybody.
Well, actually, does this go with that?
Yeah, it's a two-page.
See, it's all three.
Kelly, you think you have CJ?
What's wrong with you? Yeah.
And what's the other one?
Aqua Paradise Pools is definitely in, so, I mean, I just need a check. I mean, you know, who am I writing a check to?
Rollinsford Rec.
Rollinsford Recreation, right?
No, you don't have a separate account.
So the town.
Town of Rollinsford Memo Rec Department.
Ooh, I am so glad you told me.
Is there anybody getting this?
Why can't you? But
all of our registration was going to Rollinsford Recreation on our registration form.
It would appear that you got the open account. I think that's what my check is written out to.
Yeah, I think that was.
I think that's what we just got.
Hold on, let me look.
Is there any way to make this one page versus two?
What if we do it double-sided?
We do it double-sided.
Does it need to?
Well, we just canceled out the whole bottom.
I'm just looking at this and.
Yeah, it might end up short enough to fit on one page.
I'm just thinking it's just near, easier, cost less. And, you know, you lose one piece or don't know to turn it over.
One thing's a letter and one thing's an explanation of love.
So, one's to invite them to do it and the other one's to tell them how much to pay.
I lose it.
I knew I had read that.
It'll be very established. I don't read anything anyway.
Okay, Kelly, did you get a second on your motion when you made it to accept the sponsorship tiers? We all said yay.
Yeah.
But I didn't hear a second.
So Joey, we need to find out what the.
I'm asking right now.
Okay, thank you.
And all in favor, we'll do that again.
We would have to have an account, right? Because, I mean, that's a lot of.
You can't have your own account.
You can't.
But I thought our checking account.
That was illegal.
So that checking account we had is closed?
It's not closed yet, but it has to.
Watch the bills. Okay.
No, I don't mean the sound book, but yeah.
No, it's fine.
So, yeah, so there has to, you have the same policy procedures as everybody else, the fire chief, the police chief. So you have to put in purchasing orders. You can't be holding a checking account that it has access to town funds.
So if they run low on balls and need to get some kickballs, they have to put in a purchase order report?
You're going to be putting in purchase orders for stuff that you need ahead of time, and then you're going to have purchasing power during the year. But you don't have a checkbook.
No, but if they write the check out to that, can
I'm asking take right
that and put it in or something?
So, yes, I'm asking right now. Yes. I don't know. Like your purchase order for,
So is somebody doing like a QuickBooks that shows all payments coming in from the rec, showing what we're getting for donations,
Yes.
So it's all going to be QuickBooks that shows like what the summer rec has collected in all funds.
You have your own line item. When you look at the town book, you have a code. Town, summer rec, town item. There's a code number. So when you send in a purchasing order this week for the state parks, we didn't have a purchase order to go with it, a PO to go with it, so we couldn't approve it.
So, Blanky, that was a great question, because who's going to be keeping track of our disease, and who should keep track? Is that say within the committee that
you're
going to keep track of?
You're going to be bringing them to the select board.
Okay.
Just like the police, just like the fire, just like everybody.
So it's the select board keeping track of it? Do we need to keep track of it also?
You're going to bring it to us,
So the select board's keeping track of how much money we're bringing in and spending, but.
Oh, Caroline,
Okay.
But somebody on the committee should.
You're gonna be bringing it or just over, you're gonna be.
Oh, shall we keep our.
So I think internally we should.
Oh, yeah, you should do.
We have the reference coming out, but we package it up and get it to the select board.
Yeah, but you're here every Monday, every night anyway, so you're just gonna be like, I need a purchase order for whatever.
So if you need a purchase order.
Okay, so when I, brought that to Caroline for the New Hampshire State Parks, she basically tabled it because she wanted to wait until the town meeting happened before we do any purchasing order, was that?
Well, two reasons, there was no purchase order to go with it, we had no paper to go with it.
And where did we get that?
We were supposed to fill out a paper.
A purchase order.
So wasn't Caroline that told me that though? I was there, I thought it was personally, and I said, here, what do I do about this?
She probably didn't even think of it.
Anyway, that's what happened in my car.
Most of our purchase orders on Monday were tabled because of town meeting this week.
Right.
Because we don't know what our bottom line's gonna be.
Right, and that's kind of what she, which I was like, that's fine.
Yeah.
But I just need to know, so do I need to come out and so fill something out, hopefully after Saturday, then, you know? Right?
Yeah.
I'll do the purchase, okay.
You can just, I can just get the purchase order before the meeting, I can fill it out for you.
Oh, okay.
But we had nothing to sign, Suzanne, once we vote on it, we have to, Suzanne signs them.
Yeah.
There was nothing to sign.
Okay.
And that's not your fault, that's not anybody's fault, so.
So I like the idea of somebody within the committee.
Yeah.
Doing a checks and balances, what are we bringing in, what are we spending, as well as having Caroline do it for the town. So that way it's double verified and we know where we stand, and if any questions come up about what monies we've spent and so forth, we can go back and verify.
That would be like a treasurer, quote unquote.
Yes, our.
To be officially.
Our treasurer resigned because she's not able to make the meeting Sunday night.
So we need somebody to volunteer internally within us to keep track of stuff. Seriously.
Who's good with numbers?
I can do it, I'll do it.
I'll do it.
You're pretty organized too.
You wanna do it?
I will happily hand it over if you wanna do it.
I'll do it.
Okay, so we'll funnel everything through, so you'll need, you've got a copy of the budget, you've got, you have a hard copy of the budget.
Oh, no, the paper, she's not gonna read it.
Because you have it to compare to, like what's coming in, what's going out.
Shoot it to me.
X on the floor.
The person that doesn't. Lester, so we'll, so as I get registrations in, I'll funnel through you what money's coming in.
Okay.
And so you'll keep track of that, and every 2 weeks you'll be on the agenda, just let us know where we're at status-wise. Sound good?
Sounds fair.
Okay.
Alright, so here's the report back from Caroline. That is a good question, we have an account called Rollinsford Rec that we were depositing to, but the board decided to get rid of that account, so we need to talk about that. It would be much better if the checks were made after the town of Rollinsford. I'll talk to Suzanne about it tomorrow morning and place it on the agenda for you on Monday night. In the meantime, I would instruct people to make it out to the town of Rollinsford, it makes, it solves the problem, makes sense?
So sponsorship checks made out to the town.
Okay, so that means that everything's gonna be updated, you've gotta repost.
So if they come to town of Rollinsford, how are you gonna know that they're for the rec, because of the envelope?
The.
The memo.
There's a memo on the check and.
Oh, yeah.
You're gonna get the whole packet, so.
All together.
Yeah.
They're not just gonna send a check.
Next year, it won't be like this, we're gonna pay online.
Yeah, it would be awesome.
Can't, town funds.
You can't get into 2016.
No, as Suzanne puts it, we will eventually get to the 1990s.
It's actually.
Guys, we're on the board, that's the thing.
Okay, anyway, so, I think, this.
Not for not, Alex.
Should the town fund the memo, Camp Raleigh?
What's that?
Did that clock stop?
Game.
No, it's an hour behind.
Oh, it's an hour behind, okay, that would make sense.
No, it was seven, no.
Something is not going.
It was 7:07, I wanna call it one.
Yeah, it just, I just looked before and the minute hand was gone.
Okay.
Haunted town hall.
So it's 8:06, right?
Yeah.
8:06.
Okay.
It's
So for the sponsors, like, when do they need their information in by?
Yeah, tell us that date again, that's important.
I'll let you read that over since I updated it. I have that information. Friday the 19th, the last day to get sponsorship logos to Kristen.
Say that one more time.
May 19th is the last day.
Oh, I think you're gonna have them fast.
Yeah.
You're gonna get five really fast.
So May 19th is the one.
I think if you made that.
How do we stop them if we give this out and they go, okay, I'm gonna.
Should there be three people doing it on this, that's why.
Well, what I'm thinking.
Too many people talking.
My question is, if we pass these out and, okay, I gotta speak with whomever at my business, and then they say, okay, and we then send in a check, who's to stop nine checks from coming in?
Yeah.
Communication.
Yeah.
Went up to, like, that one.
I don't think you're gonna send out too many, cause I think they're gonna fill up really fast. Like, you've already, you'll be amazed, when you talk to people, you'll get a good idea right away. If you talk to people, you get them too, instead of just mass mailing. Unless you wanna do, I know you already voted on it, but if you did, if the 120 was, like, name on shirt, look for companies, you would get a lot of those companies.
Yeah.
You would get a lot more money.
So we should put an expiration date on that?
Yeah, absolutely.
But, yeah, the 19th is just so that we can get them on shirt.
I suppose this one is safe, probably, we're not coming soon.
Yeah, I know, that's true, but, yeah, it's true.
So I'm just gonna put May, by May 19th, that's gonna be considered longer.
Yeah.
Chasing.
So, did we come up with a conclusion on how do we stop? Like, we have five top tiers.
Let's not worry about it.
I don't know.
More than Mary.
But it is true, if you made the 120 on shirt, instead of making it just for private citizens, you would get a lot of 120s. I know you already voted.
If we got five quickly, then we know we can add two or three more top sponsorship slots, right? You think? But we'll just play it by ear as we go along, to Colin's point.
That's true, you could get, because you're not really doing a second layer on the shirt, you could just do a couple, increase the number to seven. Eventually, you still wanna start shrinking them.
You did, that's all Dan, yeah, it's all Dan.
Some of this Joey's, it's dual effort.
Is that you don't want people to think that it's an actual camp. It's a day camp, but it's not like, so it is good to sometimes say Camp Raleigh Summer Rec. Like, I would almost say, like, the first time you mention it in a document, say Camp Raleigh Summer Rec, just so people know it's summer rec, cause not everybody knows what that is.
Yeah.
It's not just, it's not like a sleepaway camp.
Summer rec to Camp Raleigh or something.
Yeah, yep.
All right, we good?
Yeah.
T-shirts, good?
Yeah, good.
So we have the sponsorships down, we have three of us that are gonna go to, and we already have two sponsors coming in, and we're gonna, the three of us will work on the other sponsors.
Yep.
And then, so I think that.
Who's painting the list and how many?
Kelly is going to create the list, the sign-up sheet at town meeting.
Oh, yeah, I'll do that.
Who's gonna be holding the list?
Or what are we talking about, t-shirts?
I'll be there, at town meetings.
Are you sitting at a table?
We got an email from Suzanne, I did, about a table. I'll be in the room.
You're gonna be in the room?
Yeah, is somebody gonna be sitting at the table watching the list or answering questions?
Yeah, I'll be there. I'll be.
And then just go in for your vote.
Yep. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Can you set the table with me?
Sure. Tell me when to vote.
Can I set the table with you?
No, you can't.
Do you have a table?
You have a table.
I have a table, yes. I do have a table to bring for you, yes.
Okay, so you've got a table.
Just in case the school doesn't have one, I'll bring it just in case.
So I think this week, so you'll be at the table, Kelly and me. And we'll talk about what we need to do.
I'm not sure how promptly I'm gonna be there, I'm gonna be coming in from Manchester in the morning, so I'll definitely get to town meeting, so.
All right, so I'll just send notes between us to figure out what we're gonna have, like, we'll print out a whole bunch of stuff and.
Sounds good.
Get ready for that.
So you're gonna have the sign-up sheet for t-shirts.
Yep.
And I can take it back and forward it to Kristen at the end of the day if you want.
Yeah.
Or we can just come up with a, look at the numbers and I can let her know how many we're looking at from that.
No, you can take it.
Okay. How? What are we talking about turnaround time for these people that are ordering on Saturday?
Yeah, that's the thing. I would let people order right up until the end.
But when are they getting, when are we telling them, you get your shirt?
They'll all be printed at once, so.
This one.
Wrong, thank you.
We need that also for Saturday.
The 12th of June.
So there, so people.
They're just gonna get printed when everyone else's does, because that's how you get it.
Okay, so we need to let people know that on Saturday, that they're not getting a shirt until the 12th of June.
Yeah.
So June 12th, okay.
Yep.
So we're taking orders through what date?
You can take orders right up until, when's the day we need numbers? The 20th, May 20th.
Take orders through May 20th.
So we can even put something on the website, you can put them on Facebook, yeah. Posters at the post office. Buy a shirt.
I need to get that shirt out on Facebook too.
Okay.
The gray one.
Yep.
Do I have this? Do we have this on a, is it on a drive?
I'll make you a better.
I will, yeah, can you send it to me?
I'll make you a better mock-up, that's a really quick mock-up.
Yeah, send me one of those and I'll.
And mold it out.
We had a question from Roxanne about the, I just have the Facebook page up and we're talking about, you know, rebranding the camp, the Camp Raleigh and maybe switching out some of that, because we have some Summer Rec 2017 titles on the Facebook page.
Yeah.
I think having boat fair helps, just to, is this a new camp, is it a go-away?
Right, right, right.
Right, exactly.
So just having a boat.
Maybe gradually.
Next year, the year after, it can just be camp.
Because like the, you search Raleigh for Summer Rec.
We're the only ones who know.
Yeah.
Because even when I first did it, people were like, what?
Right.
Right.
I was like, yeah, but you could call it both, it's okay.
I think that's a good point.
Gradually phase it out.
So phase it out, next year we'll do 100% of the following.
The kids will adopt it faster than us.
Yeah. Okay.
That was a great article in the Fosters. But the only thing, a couple days later, I don't know if you saw in the Fosters, they had all the summer camps.
Yes, somebody told me that.
And ours wasn't there.
Oh, no.
You would have thought, because they just interviewed you.
That's funny.
But we didn't pay them, so.
I don't think they, I think they do that for free.
Oh, really?
I don't know. I don't know. We missed that, that was a missed opportunity then.
Yeah, somebody else told me about that.
Not for free.
Oh, well, yeah, I don't think they would have done that.
I did look.
We got a good section, it's a big black summer camp, but come on, it was better than that little.
To pay for that would have been $1,000 usually.
And I did look, it's something like $200 to $300 to get an ad for the help wanted.
Right.
In Fosters or Seacoast Online.
That's crazy.
See, free advertising.
Yep.
All right, so are we all set with t-shirt business?
So they will be printed for June out to be picked up or.
Orders through May 20th and we'll get it June 12th. Or it'll be available.
Orders taken until May 20th and we're gonna post the shirts on Facebook and Kristen's gonna get us a better picture to post on Facebook and for town meeting. Is that all correct?
Yep.
Okay, just making sure I got it down on my notes.
Yeah, I can post the t-shirt on there.
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
You know, you have access to the logos and everything. Makes more sense, I think.
Jody, did you have a chance to have a discussion? I'm gonna revisit a, unless you can tell me, the walkers and the older kids about walking to camp, as Lester brought it up last time. I talked to the Summers Rec camp director and I asked them what they did, because their camp is at Pines, Noble Pines. So they have walkers, and she gave me a copy of their waiver that they have. And I just think for, I don't know if you guys want to buy, I have a couple, I printed out a couple of them. But, you know.
I thought how we decided last weekend before. This committee decided.
It's in my minutes and I have it.
I thought that was.
Okay. Review of pickup permission slips leads to a debate on the sign in and sign out procedures. People have been persistent in the practice of children signing themselves in and out must be stopped. It was one of the requirements placed on this committee to ensure the safety of the campers in future years by the select board. The question and concern was raised about those campers that arrive alone in the morning. It was reiterated that all children must be signed in and out by an adult. Concerns about those arriving alone can be taken to the select board by the ex officiato if necessary. Someone asked about those that live just down the road, why can't we have them walk and check themselves in? Concerns about liability were brought up again. Is the town or the committee liable if those campers who show up alone are turned away? It was stated that older children would be capable of walking back and forth. Another matter discussed is whether the committee would eliminate some kids, some children in the community by not allowing them to sign themselves in and out. And we should ask the select board to consider allowing kids to walk and check themselves in while still requiring an adult to check them out. Apprehension was expressed that about those who do not show up, who are supposed to walk, and what do we do in that case? Past practices have proven to be irresponsible for the current times. In the end, it was decided that if a child shows up alone, a call will be made to a responsible adult while the child sits at the desk. The child or children will have to remain at the desk until a responsible adult signs them in all day if necessary.
And I guess, I don't know, I guess I thought about a couple of things and maybe we need to, you know, and Lester, you're kind of a good example, and I can think of somebody right now, like Lauren Cruz, right? She's a sixth grader right now going into seventh grade. One of her parents.
You're talking about personal information.
Oh, sorry. I mean, okay, I know a sixth grader.
Well, I think the problem was for lunch. Kids not coming back in the afternoon, just staying home, I think.
Well, that was like
well what happens if they don't show up? Like, they're supposed to walk, and they just decide that day they're not going to come. Every time they don't show up, we have to call a parent now. And then the parent has to go home and get them or do something about them.
And I bring up this person just because they have two parents that work early. So if you have two parents that go to work early,
and your child's old enough to walk themselves,
they're old enough people going into seventh, eighth, ninth grade that,
and they can walk their sibling.
All I just said is Summer Reserve does it a different way. So I did want to bring that up, and then I found out what they do, because they have the same situation that we do.
But they have a staff. They have the ability to call.
Well, why don't we have that ability to call? We have a staff. We do have a staff. We have a staff of like 12 people.
We are starting a new precedence. So unfortunately, because of past actions, we have to step our game up this year. If we want to go a little easier next year, maybe. But we had people dismissing themselves, not showing up, parents not knowing where they were, staff not knowing where they were. We had children missing. And we can't decide whose responsibility is it when, is it the town's responsibility? My child was supposed to be at your daycare. Well, I don't know if they showed up or not. That's why it's the parents' responsibility to get them there. If I have to drop them off at Blythe's house at 6 a.m. and Blythe brings all of them, so be it.
Blythe just has to be listed as one of your
parents.
Emergency
people. My sister-in-law is going to be dropping off my children because the class, you guys start at 8 and I need to be at work for 8.
And I think that's
so my children are going to Megan's house and Megan's dropping off all four.
Hey, you're dropping off.
I think as long as that is going to be, as I mentioned last week, that's going to be a huge objection because it's so convenient for a number of families. And the only reason I can do it is because I work from home, so I can take 5 minutes and run them up well. Actually, his sister, who's now 18, can just sign him in. But so I think that if we diffuse it by, you know, well, hey, do you have a friend or a family member that, you know, is also going that can just, you know, carpool?
Right. I have a big, and actually, Mel and I lead into my next idea.
I think of two things. I think one is some of the kids that live in the area already, the school already allows them to bike and walk to school without potential supervision, assuming that's what they do, you know, during the summer or spring or whatever. So if I'm a parent, I'm saying, well, why can't I do it now? You know, why can't
Select board said no. So right. The answer is no. So
right.
That's it. It's no.
So there's the argument for that.
Right. Out of our control.
Mm-hmm. Roxanne brought up what we're here for.
Seriously.
Roxanne brought up a point that, like Lester, your daughter's 18. If she has a friend or somebody who's 16.
Well, my son's 16.
Or
he has to pick them up sometimes. So.
Is he allowed to sign them out as an adult?
I mean, he's old enough. So.
He can drive them, but can't he now sign them?
Is there an age limit on the adult?
It'll be a question for the select board.
What is the age limit for someone to be able to sign someone in or out?
A sibling, maybe, not just
any
random.
16-year-old.
I can see his.
They would have to be listed on the emergency contact, right? That's how I see it.
And to be on the emergency contact, I assume you have to be able to give medical.
We got to go there because. A little snack food when I sold hiking.
Registration? Which part? Emergency thing?
There's no nothing there for like insurance.
There's no subscriber information.
Oh, but really?
Like, Liberals pushing out of there.
So I'm surprised that we didn't have it. And one of us didn't catch it.
I didn't catch it until I was filling it out. I was like, what?
Mm-hmm. I don't mean Barrett didn't do it, which.
That's kind of amazing.
Okay,
so
basically we reviewed the sign in and out procedures again because Somersworth has a different policy and they have the staff that can call homes if needed. And there was a discussion about whether it's convenient or safe and so forth. And then the question was asked, is there an age limit on when they can sign in and out? And that's to go to the select board. Does that cover the
I mean, I think 16 sounds like a good number. If we can recommend or ask something of the select board because of their own drive.
Well, we're also hiring 16-year-olds.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, they can, you know.
So we can have a 16-year-old sibling be working there, but they can't bring their brother or sister there.
But they're not legal. They're not legal. They can't come. A 16-year-old cannot go to the dental office and get a cleaning because their parent's not with them. They cannot sign their own medical history forms. Yeah, they can drive.
It's true. You went to college. You send a medical history form every time you roll into the dentist.
17. Do it. Most dentists, yes, you're supposed to. Once a year, it should be updated.
Sign everything.
But at the same time, when you go to the dentist, you don't have a 16-year-old working on your teeth. But we have a 16-year-old watching.
I'm not saying the laws are great.
I'm just saying, as much
they
as
they can
like,
get their teeth cleaned, but they can get prenatal care. I'm just saying, it's not the way I wrote the law, I just have to follow the law.
So is this a closed thing already? They said no, like even
I'll bring
the
sign
off,
this
it's survivable?
We wanted signing in and out, yes. The board wanted signing in and out, but I will ask them about 16-year-olds. And will they revisit the issue of walkers? How's that? Does that sound good?
Yeah.
So I'm putting it on the agenda right now.
I think that there could be a couple of staff that could call parents. I don't see why they couldn't make calls between like 9 and 10 after everyone's supposed to be there and off doing the games or whatever. Just someone just sit there and make calls to their parents.
Right, so as registrations come in, we know because they've indicated that they can walk or, well, no, we took that out.
He took it out.
We took it out entirely, so.
We want to limit that kind of responsibility just because once kids start showing up, things get really chaotic and really things start going and to have to pull somebody away and say, okay, you've got to call all these people.
And then you're not, you may lose your 8-1.
Right.
If you have a bunch of campers there and you're only missing a handful, that then you have to call. But that brings me to the point of what happens if you're on vacation? You're paying for the whole summer.
you're taking the week off vacation. Is the parents notifying the camp that you're not going to be there for a week because you're going to vacation? I know the first week of August, I'm always gone.
Yeah, I've done that. I did that last summer. Yeah, not going to be here.
And then are they calling you because you're not showing up?
Well, it'll be...
Not if you advise them.
Yeah, they're going to say something.
All right, I like that Jody's just going to revisit and we'll just...
We'll talk about that next.
Yeah, we'll revisit that.
Or if you get some information, you can send it to us.
Yep.
Thank you.
Next.
So, yeah, well, I don't know. I don't know if I should bring this up because just hearing what just all happened, but I'm going to bring it up anyway. I am. I thought, well, I've had an idea because my, you know, my big issue with teenagers and not doing anything, mostly 14 and 15 year olds going into 9th and 10th grade. I've asked a couple of kids what would get you here, maybe not necessarily for a full day. A couple of the 8th graders, including my own child, who I don't want sitting in my house all day long, I said, what do you think about having a half-day camp? 1 to 4 for that age group. They can sleep all morning. They can sleep all morning. And we have a scheduled like physical activity for that age group at 1 o'clock. Like Mondays, it's volleyball, Tuesdays or whatever, Wednesdays it's inside basketball.
What are you leaving to the state parks on Tuesdays?
Thursdays. Well, and I was going to ask what everybody was, oh, early, 9:30.
It was 9:30.
Yeah, so they're not attending.
Well, that would be a question. Like, would we open that up to swimming and the state park trip for those kids as well? Or just have it a 4-day camp with the swimming, or have it just 3 days and nix them out. I like the idea of those age group, those kids who can't get a job and who don't drive, to be doing something.
But now we're back to square one. How do those kids get there for 1 o'clock? They're all going to be walking there,
yeah,
right. And then we're going to make them all sit there for 4 hours until their parents get there.
Well, that's why I said, I don't know if I should even bring this up now after the conversation that we just had, but I feel that there's a population for those kids there's in our town that...
I think we had talked about that, like having a block of activity where they could sign up for that activity and pay a fee.
Yeah, like this would be like, you know, I don't know, I kind of was doing... I subtracted the hours or whatever. I figured it would be like $17.50 per week if we did it for X amount of hours, like 3 hours a day or something. Prorate it from what we're charging right now.
But we go from 8 to 1 to a 16 to 1 ratio all of a sudden.
Well, with those kids, yeah.
So that's my
That would be
one
like
concern.
one person, like a ref. We'll sign you up.
Yeah.
It's a whole kind of separate
thing. I mean, I think we already sort of talked about this and decided it's kind of like a second camp. And as much as I hear your pain, and I have an older one as well, actually, he just actually slips in under this, but next year he wouldn't.
Right.
But I think we need to get this fixed and on track. It's like all of a sudden trying to start up two new companies.
I'm gonna get them there by having them help with some little something for
Canada.
Oh, I mean,
that,
if you're paying them
back
to
16
kids. Well, not working, just like.
We had volunteers
like
last year.
Coaches.
And my daughter can tell you the
team
volunteer
captains.
14-year-olds sat there on their Game Boys.
Oh, I know.
Even when they tried to get them to do something. So it's a good thing on paper, but.
Oh yeah, definitely. But she was there for free.
Though, right?
Like,
no,
tablets, no phones for the kids.
Yeah, no tablets.
Well, you and I talked about that question was out on the table. Do we tell them no electronics, period? But what about their cell phones? They're not allowed to be having their cell phones in their hands at all times.
Yeah,
it's
all
they can
have.
Like contact. Mm-hmm. They have to stay with
the counselors. They have to stay with the head counselor.
The cell phones?
Yeah.
But now we're talking about a liability.
No camp has ever had cell phones
can have them at school.
But this is 2017.
You can have them in the middle school and the high school.
But we're not talking about middle schoolers and high schoolers.
But you are.
Second graders.
You're gonna have them there at your camp.
I don't know how many second graders are actually gonna have them.
Even our fifth and sixth graders have, some fifth and sixth graders have them.
Why are we taking them away from them?
They say maybe have it, but don't use it. That's what they do.
Because what we don't want is, because I actually heard, and Jordan, you might be able to tell us, were there kids like at camp that just played on cell phones? Like there are kids that blatantly didn't want to participate in activities because they were doing this on their.
Were you able to stop them from playing on their phone and participating in the group? If they were a sixth, seventh, or eighth grader?
The counselors were doing it.
The counselors were.
I heard that, so a lot of the.
Counselors were on their phones.
And that's why you guys are here, I'm so excited.
We had, St. Thomas, every classroom has like, you know, those shoe racks that hang on the doors, you know, every classroom has one of those, and the kids are supposed to put their phones in those.
With everyone out playing, counselors, and there's a bunch of phones sitting there.
But it could be a situation where they, if they want it, they check it in at the beginning of the day. Because I have a feeling there are gonna be some parents who say, no, my kid has to have their cell phone because I want an emergency.
It's a GPS, my kid gets taken, I can find them.
It's just the way it is now. But if we had a central location, this is where the phones go.
And then what happens when Johnny's phone is missing?
Right.
Yeah.
Who's now paying for that, the $400 phone?
Don't you have insurance on it to begin with?
You always put a disclaimer out there.
Johnny.
Not Johnny.
Yeah, we could, Johnny's paper, like.
Right, because on the parent handbook, it says absolutely none, but we could change it to.
Our rule is if you drop it, you get the phone, the old flip phone that we have in the basement, so there you go.
He's evil.
Right.
Ask her.
This is her last phone number, but her, she knows it. Not have to go through a camp counselor to do it. I'm saying, okay, I'm gonna be there.
I don't need people like trying me.
We have to go on the plane, I'm like, don't.
So.
Is that something we need to clear through the select board if we do decide to let them keep?
I'm not sure, but I'll ask them anyway, since we're, I'll even ask about the teen camp to begin with. So we have at least an answer, and if last minute, we can put one together.
Because, and also, well, the problem with that is, as everybody kind of pointed out too, is those kids are gonna be walking, right? And.
Right.
So maybe the select board comes back and says, no walkers unless they're over the age of 13.
Right.
Or 14, okay.
Or enrolled in the teen camp.
The teen camp.
I'm just apprehensive about trying to set up two, like Lester said. It's, we already have a camp that we're moving quickly on. And I'm just afraid we're gonna be going even faster for the teen camp, and are we going to be forgetting something? Is there going to be things falling through the cracks?
There's probably going to be something that falls through the cracks. I don't think we can.
I mean,
we should just plan on that happening.
And this is the first year. Shouldn't we try and get, like, try and match our numbers as close as we can, try and keep within our budget, and then next year, when we have the experience of the first year down, move on to expanding it to a second program?
Yes, no. I mean, I agree with, but if we're revamping, we're revamping, you know? This is a whole new.
Yeah. We may not have answers this week because town meeting is Tuesday and Saturday.
Yeah.
So depending on how long tomorrow night's meeting is, we might get tabled anyway.
Right.
My other question is we accept out-of-town residents here, and you're looking for places to send your 14 and 15-year-old. Can they go to like Camp Cool or to the Somersworth camp? Do other towns accept camp kids of those ages where you would just be able to do a loop and say, as we're not offering it here, but these camps offer it if you're looking for somebody in that age range?
They both accept people from other towns.
Well, you're just trying to get the kids to want to be there, right?
Right.
Yeah, not, I mean, we have the age from this to this. And those volunteers last year weren't registered campers. They were like wanderers almost. It was wandering. It was just there.
Yeah.
One of my little guy loved her, but she was like, yeah, I'm just hanging out. I was like, oh. Well, she was Snapchatting my son pictures of his little brother all day. It was kind of like, she was nice, but she was not a registered camper. She was just wandered in, and then she'd leave, and the camp would come. So
I think if they're registered and supposed to be there, they're supposed to their parents, shove them in. Or, a lot of times girls like to hang with the little kids. When I said like organize, I didn't mean employ them, but like sometimes they like to play with kids and get a team going. And
well, and it also brings up too, my daughter's starting, and I think you talked about it too, with even the 50 hours of volunteer work that Marshwood High School requires. So, not that the teen camp has anything to do with that, but that was a second area that somebody asked me, can so-and-so wants to volunteer at the summer camp?
Instead of taking a paycheck?
Yes.
I get them.
A 14-year-old or 15?
He's going into, he'll be a sophomore next year, so that's...
So 16?
Probably 15.
Maybe 16.
Yeah, to get his 50 hours out of the way. So are we looking for that?
They have to be 16, right, to even,
for
counseling, to that answer.
Okay.
Got turned 16.
Well, that's for it to be paid and to be like responsible and CPR certified. These kids are volunteers, like help gather all these balls and clean up at the end of the day.
Or like I was even thinking like, okay, if we're walking the kids to the library today, like we have a couple of high school volunteers who want to get a couple hours.
Who's signing off on the hours?
You would say, I don't know anything about it. Like,
they had a hockey coach sign off on Ethan's.
That could be another question for the select board if they can allow 14, 15 year old volunteers.
We wouldn't have to report.
I will ask them because I'm not giving
you
my opinion.
Well,
so
I think one way around that might be because the mom of the girl that you mentioned was mentioning that her older son likes to fish, and
yeah.
He is, what, he's a sophomore in high school, and if he gave like a fishing demonstration, so like if they have a
and that would be a couple hours of community service,
yeah.
Right?
That'd be a good way to do it, because then the kid would have a purpose.
Right.
It could be their day, they have their activity, something they're good at.
Yeah,
but
so
today we're going to do solder.
Solder.
That's what he
really just solder.
Yeah, well, that's what we do.
Today we're sharpening swords.
Solder at our house. Fire
that's
making
funny.
Solder.
Have you met my twins? No.
We do a lot of
you know how we ask for volunteers from the community to you know, offer their services. So if this is a young girl that knows how to do French braids,
yeah.
And
oh,
she would like... She would like to offer her and volunteer to do the French braids. That would be her offering her service.
And then you have a flock of little girls surrounding her.
Yeah.
I don't know French braids.
I think that would, but that would be like a done deal. Like she's there
exactly.
For 2 hours.
Yeah, then
right.
And
then
she's done or whatever.
Yeah,
she wants to braid once a week for 2
yeah.
hours and she's done.
Maybe we need to, well, I guess we'd have to get a... I'm okay about that, but we have to incorporate that. Maybe have a certain time during the week.
Yeah,
weekly.
Demo time.
Mm.
I think we did carve out a section for that demo. It was on Fridays or one of the days. Yeah, it's a good point, though. So if we can get that approved, then we should start thinking about carving out a certain time during the week.
Well, there's a difference between having camper helpers and having people come in with skills to... work with the kids and show them the skills.
Well, French braiding is a skill, but it's not.
No, I'm saying it is a skill.
It is, but it's also extremely fun.
No, my wife just learned.
You know,
she was so happy.
So simple.
Huh?
Oh my God, I can do my own.
Now we're requiring background checks on all the staff and all of our volunteers who are wanting to go in and participate. So what about background checks for these people who want to come in and give a demonstration or work with the kids for a couple of hours a week?
We don't do background checks to let them go to school.
Well, I think we got a little sidetracked. They would be registered campers, just trying to get those older kids to want to be there. Like, why don't you show the girls library today? Or, you know, like, just take ways to get the teenagers
so
in that
awkward...
So you're
talking about a 7th or 8th grader?
Well, like, she was in this awkward stage where they can't drive, they can't work. But they're sitting at home on the couch all summer, which I have.
But they wouldn't be registered campers because they're too old to be registered campers.
No, how old?
No, 8th grade.
8th grade going into 9th is too old.
Oh, so yeah. Then the other is that.
So then I guess we would have to do a background check. I don't know, she's kind of shady.
Have you held up a store?
Those Andersons.
Yeah. Well, I've seen our four together. They're going to have their hands full.
So, Select Board's going to get back to us and look into can 14 or 15-year-olds come and
volunteer
skill of some kind.
Demo.
Demonstrate
skills. Yeah, that was the whole thing. I thought it was in the age group that could be a camper. Just not.
Well, I'm sure if there's a registered camper that knows how to basket weave, they can just bring the stuff and show the kids how to basket.
I was talking about you giving her an idea to want to get her there or him there. Like, or whatever, just to, so they have a purpose, so they don't just want to, because some of these kids don't want to go to summer rec.
No, but I'm talking about my daughter who is too old for summer rec, but she's going to be 14 in July, so what is she doing?
What is she doing?
You can get her a background check, she'll be in.
So we have to wait for Select Board on that.
Yeah, what am I asking them?
I don't know.
If a person that's too old to be a camper, but too young to be employed, can come either one as a camper helper, or two can come.
They can't be a camper helper. I decided that as a Select Board.
I can ask them again.
Perfect. Yeah. So then, can they come at a set time, either weekly, or a one-time deal to demonstrate a skill or.
To get community service hours.
For
but they would have to have some sort of skill or something that they're showing. They can't just show up and be like, I can sweep floors.
Right.
A lot of kids might be.
I think
like,
that would be
scouting
fabulous.
Like that, they might have skills.
Oh, yeah,
skills.
Scouting
like,
skills.
You know,
that's
skills.
That's me.
Washing my
windows.
Or they have jewelry making.
Yeah.
I want
them to
do it. And that increases the quality of our camp, too.
Right.
Stuff.
So this is what I have. What about volunteers to work towards graduation qualifications or requirements? Who signs off on their hours? What were their responsibilities or duties of the volunteers? Maybe have the kids come through activities and demonstrations of things they enjoy, like a demo time. We'll check, please check in with the Select Board regarding volunteers and do volunteer, if they're allowed. And then if they needed background checks or whatever, because we're going to need them. I don't know, Jody.
That
maybe they don't know.
Better than everything we just said.
So far, sorry for so many emails. 14, 15-year-olds need volunteer hours for high school. Could they come and show a skill or demo time?
Yep.
Is that all you want?
Without a background check.
Yeah.
Let's put that in there.
Yeah.
Let's put in like on dance like, for example,
how much is for background
or scouts
or a fishing demo.
Something like that.
We're not just against.
Usually it's 2 years. A coaching sports like
that. Yeah, want to build a rock.
A coach, so like Bill has to have one
fun thing that
right.
Has
yeah.
Some developers over there, you know?
They're good for 2 years.
Actually,
the kid at St. Does anyone know if we can background check a child, a 16-year-old, to begin with?
Wow.
Is that something that can be done?
Can't imagine.
Violence never a kid.
Yeah, I mean, has anyone checked
into that? There's no age for that, is there, Joe?
I don't think so.
Juvenile records are sealed anyway. They're not going to. Do you need permission to check them?
You could do it, but they'd all come back clean?
Places that require them for employment don't hire before 18. Like a company
like a credit check, kids don't have a credit report until 18.
Any other topic items?
I did get another, so we do need to, I think we need to hire a director as soon as possible. So we need to get any of the committee, does anybody have any kind of leads on that? Does that, not mine?
You gave me those two.
Did I forward you the?
You gave me two?
But I.
I know I have one.
Resumes?
Molly. And then did you get the,
Molly's.
Brittany Powers one, she sent.
No. Do you want to set up interview time?
She, well, I wanted to tell you, both of those girls are home from college, and I know you don't want to hear this, this week. So.
Well, I'll be here all day Tuesday.
Maybe.
Is that what, are they gonna have the town vote with the weather?
They have up till 2 hours before to decide, I believe.
2 hours? So by 5 AM?
It's initially like 18 plus now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So the background check will be Monday, and the moderator decides that, I believe. Let me break the fourth wall, I believe.
So this, so that resume.
I didn't know about the waters, I will be honest.
So if, I don't know, we have a blizzard, so I don't know if you're not gonna be interviewing anybody, nobody's gonna be around that. So, and you can, Brittany Powers and.
But we can find time this weekend, the rest of.
That would be awesome, she said that.
Like, if you do evening hours, it's easier.
Well, she said she was substituting at the grade school on the 16th and 17th, I think that's Thursday and Friday.
Oh, this is,
She was a counselor?
Mrs. Powers at the school.
She was a counselor.
Yes.
Oh my god, she's level one now.
So. I'm just.
Would you like to interview your prospective boss?
Yeah.
I'm just gonna play devil's advocate, what happens if we get another great candidate that comes in the first week of April?
Well, we're just interviewing, we're not giving them a job.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, which reminds me, I'll send you the interview questions, and there's a list, I think, that.
And it's right there, I was told to hold off of it, because there were a couple of errors in it.
So we have two people that are applying for the assistant director position. I don't know if we can get one of them.
Assistant?
One to two, yeah, that's for assistant. But I think she would be happy as a counselor as well, so I don't think it's a, you know, if we just decide that the other person is a better fit and then offer her a counselor position, I think she'd be happy with that.
If I can notice it.
And maybe the other one might be too, so maybe we can just use both of them hopefully.
Our deadline is April 15th.
That's why I wanted to get out at ASAP.
Yeah, that's nice.
Did Jan look at this yet?
I know that she, I know that this Brittany had worked at the school a lot.
Yeah, he did, and I know some stuff he did too.
But the additional, she's always something for people over there.
Yeah, my kids love her.
The kids all know her.
Yeah, my kids really liked her too, and she actually sent in, did I give you the second page? So she's a science, I think she's a early education, elementary education major.
Do you wanna scratch out the stuff you have?
Actually, you know what, I'll give you copies of the ones that are actually real, the right ones.
So she's graduated then?
I don't know, does it say graduation date on that?
Says education and bachelor's.
Yeah, so maybe she.
A six pack of twelve coats.
But I feel like she's in college right now.
That's a six pack of 12 coats.
Oh my god, is that serious?
What?
So by the summer she will have.
Oh, so did.
Did I give you two?
I gave you.
And her list of science experiments?
Yeah.
I should.
I need.
He was bad, when I reached out to work, I'm like.
Wait, did you just give me your visa there?
Not yet.
So we can find other people.
Don't worry, I'll be so hard to find.
So let me have the ones that have bullets.
Does that go?
So.
Six pack of 12 coats.
And then there's, you see, oh my goodness.
This is four.
Sing on here. It's science experience, she's done her.
Six, maybe it's six packs of 12 coats.
Six packs of 12, then she's missing the S.
Oh, I bet you had 12 on.
Oh, typos on kids today.
Well, maybe that's part of the science experiment, you're gonna take six and make it 12.
Did you have the 12 ounce coat?
Yeah, because it would be.
No, I tried to get it out last week, and then it came back to me with some errors that needed to be fixed.
Fizzy ice dash ice. Fizzy ice.
Alright, come on, get this away from her.
No, this is the name of the science experiment. That would be fizzy ice is what she's calling it. You need ice, vinegar.
So why wouldn't she just do dot dot like everything? I'm gonna just pass on.
Okay, I think I'm about done, I think Jody's done.
Friends.
Rolling in Vegas.
Did you want to talk about that?
No.
That's the same.
Okay.
Do we have any besides what we discussed about where we're going from here?
Okay.
Where are we going to advertise for counselors? We talked about, I know we kind of talked about that. I mean, I know I got from something that said comes, but I can't get the anyone.
I have a connection, I have a connection on, through the UNH. I know a girl who graduated from the Recreation Management Program. There's a Facebook page that she is privy to. So if I get her, like this, she can post that on that Facebook page, which has, she told me, hundreds of people with recreation management degrees or going through school or, so I think that's a start.
More for a director, looking for a director.
Or even counseling.
Maybe is a college kid gonna want to work for $8 an hour? I don't know.
They want to go home.
But that's what we're looking for, Dan, though, if we got, if you're 18 or older. So what we.
That's just those that are concerned with the kid.
Right.
Rate of pay should be on there, is it on there? I mean.
Yes, it's on there.
Well, are we put, we're not putting out the job descriptions, are we? We're just putting out a flyer, and then once we interview them, we can give them a job description, right?
That just might be a waste of a lot of people's time.
Yeah.
But why wouldn't they see the job description?
You want to know how much you're gonna make.
Yeah. Well, and what we had listed on there for counselors was $750 to $850, because I think we have some playtime, some play in that. Yeah, like the 16-year-old, I think 16-year-olds, I'm thinking $750.
I'm just thinking college age kids.
Well, then if we have several 16-year-olds at $750, then we can afford to pay college kids $850.
Yeah. Or 10, or whatever.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Well, I don't know. If we get five corporate sponsors for $1,250, then we can, we got money to play with.
Yeah.
Right?
But we still have to come with pool and buses and all.
Yep. At that age, so my son's that age.
Except for that one to make the buses are covered.
11 is not enough.
Yeah.
Well, the bus to Jane Thompson is.
The bus
for the state park. For the state park.
State park.
Right.
The kids' park.
Right.
So
we have to look at our calendars here for next meeting day.
So, do we want to get that poster out?
This one?
Is that?
No, the job posting.
Oh, yeah, we were going to talk about that too, weren't we? We have
your
sentence.
This is my life.
That, we had talked about getting up in the schools, like Roxanne said she might be able to bring it, Dan, and I was going to take it to the Marshwood schools and those in that district. I have a contact that can take it to Garrison Elementary. I have drop it off at Summersworth and Rollinsford and get it out on the Facebook page and stuff.
Yeah.
I figure the more we get it out, the better. But I'm not thinking that we need to put the job descriptions out with that poster.
No, I'm thinking that for more information, go to, have it out on the town website. They can access the town website.
It's so ready to put out there.
Yes, I think that's, yeah. So let's get this out so that people are looking.
I'm trying to think, yeah, no, there's a little board school that I think most of the prospective employees do put the rate of pay on. Just, I'll have to check it out.
The thing about me putting it at Trade Academy is that main minimum wage went up. So if I put it there for less than what?
What's main minimum wage now?
Nine.
Nine?
Really?
So if I put it at Trade Academy for your seven, it's not.
Yeah, right.
Well, if you resign, well, yeah.
Well, my son just got a job at Bogarty's and they.
Yes.
I just quit.
They were paying you nine?
No, the people in the back. Because I get tips.
Oh, that's right. That's right, you get tips.
So they, we live here, so we just there.
So if they live in Maine and they're working in New Hampshire, oh, but we're competing against.
Right. I just think it's good for me to go put it in Kittery.
I think, if anybody looked, Kathy, did you see the camp that ad in the Fosters? Because I think my in-laws actually read to me on the phone, I think Summersworth has upped their pay to 9 for counselors and 11 for directors. But, and they used to be on the lower side, so I don't know. We'll see. I mean, I think we should just see what kind of, yeah. How much interest we get, you know?
Yeah, I'm on. I couldn't do that. You don't do this much.
I mean, Brittany told me she was getting paid $8 an hour last year.
Let's get it next month, okay. That's what we do.
Operate 50. She should be pretty happy, right?
Brittany.
Would you be happy with that? Are you applying?
Please apply.
She's watching and deciding.
Don't take this and do it.
I know.
Kelly, ideally, when you're thinking of the staff, you know, I mean, we talked about, you know, director, assistant director being college or above.
Yeah.
Counselors, a mix of college and schools, that kind of.
Well, and I don't know if you were here, Jody told us the 16-year-olds had to, the percentage needed to be.
49%.
49%. So we need more.
So if it's 10 counselors, 6 of them have to be.
So for that posting, we want it to go ASAP. For some places like Facebook and stuff, we would like to attach the job descriptions with it.
Yes.
But for the schools that it's going out to, we would just like to put the pay rate on it and go to job description.
I think to do, if you're putting this at a school, just put this at the school and then they can go to the link and they can see the job description which has the pay rate on it.
Okay.
Because if somebody's making an effort to look it up, then they're somewhat interested, right?
Yeah, they can go find.
Yeah.
Not, so put the pay rate on it and a link or where to find the job description.
So the job descriptions have the pay rate on it.
Yes.
So you shouldn't even have to do that.
So postings need a link or an address to the job description.
Yes, so you know the one that we use at the top of the registration packet? That's the link, that's the town. It goes right direct to the board and the rec committee tab. I'll have to put out the staff application too.
Yeah, do you have anything that needs to go on there?
Are we accepting checks with St. Rollins for recreation on it?
That's
the question to you.
Right, and we'll find out, but I'm sure worst case scenario, you just call the people and
Can you check?
Well, no, you don't have to, you write your check.
No, I think you have to write a new one.
Yeah, you have to write a new one, the whole line item.
Yeah, you can just call them and don't just write a new check.
I don't
just
think
it.
No.
It came out as well. Just sign it.
Because it would be orientation at that point.
Last name W-A-L.
Because if it were I think you should just list it as that.
So, D, you're going to make sure that the job descriptions get onto the website.
Yeah, I've got it on my little to-do list.
Okay, can we look at the calendar? 2 weeks from today is March 26th.
I've already put a posting up for the next three meetings, which would be the March 26th at 7 p.m. And then April 9th at 7 p.m.
Be in St. Martin.
Here. And then I stop there because after April 9th, we get into Easter's the following week, and I don't know when school vacation falls. So the three meetings that I had posted this week are in the lobby. So we've got meetings posted until April 9th.
Okay.
That's perfect.
And then
because it is that following Sunday is Easter, and then that's the kids' vacation week.
So I didn't know if
April
9th
and the 30th? Or the 23rd? I missed what you said.
So it's the...
The 12th,
March 26th.
March 26th is posted already. It was posted with this meeting.
Yeah.
And then the next one is April 9th. It's been posted at 7 p.m. Okay. But there is nothing after that because I figured we need to talk about vacations and whether we're going to skip a week or what.
I may or may not make
skip
it.
A week.
I won't be.
We should be
I don't know the school schedule, so I wasn't sure if people were going to be available.
room. School vacation is the 17th through the.
So as long as we have a quorum, then we can keep meeting.
I am going to Puerto Rico with my.
Didn't you just get back?
I did, I love it there. Going back, I'm bringing.
The family?
All of them.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
Great.
So are we all set?
No, we never.
Wait, the only time I can interview this week is Wednesday night or Friday night.
That, you guys don't have to worry about that, right? You're looking at me for that, yeah.
Well, if you look at this book, it doesn't look good, just saying.
What'd you say, Friday night or Wednesday?
You can always interview and make a recommendation to the board.
Okay. I might be able to do Wednesday night, so maybe if we can do.
You mean if it stops snowing?
Uh-huh, yes, there's no snow.
So after four.
After four, okay, so I'll be in touch with you after I, okay, I'll contact.
All right.
Sounds good.
I'll send you guys the questions that Barrington had.
Okay.
So it's just interviews and no decisions are gonna be made until later. Okay, and are we keeping the application deadline of April 15th, or do you wanna back it up to like May 1st?
I say keep it there.
Okay, and then if we get late ones coming in, then we can interview.
You can always keep interviewing.
And if any of you just keep talking to people, do you know somebody? I mean, everybody I talk to, I'm like, hey, do you know anybody that needs a summer job? You know, that more teachers, I mean, teachers are kind of the population that are kind of need a little money, or maybe they're really bored in the summer and they have nothing else to do, or. Yeah.
But this is a different level kid, you know, I'm just saying.
I really need money, I guess that would be it.
Teachers are gonna work there.
All right, so next meeting.
Kelly, was there a reason why you brought in a t-shirt and a water bottle?
Is a camp director for the summer.
Cause you're drinking out of it?
Oh, I thought you wanted to like talk about it or something, cause that's a good idea.
No.
That's fine. That's our secret.
Oh, okay. A t-shirt and a water bottle.
I don't even know how that's made.
Okay.
I can find out.
We need a motion to adjourn.
I can't do that.
Motion to adjourn.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye. So who wants to take this?